500 hours. That's how much time I spent on this channel without making a dime when I first started. And I now recently realized that I make $390 a day at least in passive income, and this has been consistent for months. But it wasn't always this way. In order to get this point where I was making passive income, I had to go through years of failure where I wasn't making any money at all. And then when I finally did start making money, years of grinding. The truth about passive income, especially in the beginning, is that everybody wants it. And so you have to work extra hard up front in order to start generating it. And I wish I would have seen a video like this years ago so that I'd have a better understanding about how to go about generating this passive income. Because I think passive income is sort of a buzzword that people throw around and they don't actually realize what it means. I think a lot of people view passive income as money that just grows on trees, but that's not how passive income works. It's more like farming, where you're doing a ton of work up front and then you're reaping the rewards of all that hard work a long time down the line. And in this video, I'm going to show you different ways that I've been consistently generating passive income over the last year. And if you're new to the channel, people subscribe to learn about personal finance, college degrees, careers, and opportunities that are going to lead you to success. And in order to show appreciation for these videos, viewers also gently tap the like button. We don't do any of that smashing stuff here. And these kinds of videos are never easy to make. It's pretty taboo to talk about the subject of money. And it does tend to get a lot of hate comments, but after getting tons of requests to make a video like this, I decided to. So I really hope this inspires people and maybe it'll give you a few ideas on what you can do in your personal journey. All right, so the way I'm going to structure this video is I'm going to start from the most passive to the least passive types of income, because not all passive income is created equally. Some of these methods are completely passive and others are semi-passive. So first one on the list is probably my favorite form of passive income, and that is investments. Now, this last year has been absolutely bonkers when it comes to the stock market. Millionaires have been made. There's been stocks that have gone up like 10x. There's been cryptocurrencies that have gone up over 1,000%. And I have had an incredible year when it comes to investing. Now, my investments are all over the place. I invest in retirement accounts like the Roth IRA and the 401k. I think one of the safest ways of investing is to put your money into a diversified ETF or index fund. But I also invest into individual companies, and usually this is because they pay dividends or it's just a company that I really like. Maybe I'll make a lot of money from that company, maybe I won't, but either way, I'll feel really good about it because these are companies that I support. A common example of this would of course be the Teslas of the world. And my favorite app for investing in individual companies that's extremely beginner friendly is going to be Webull, which you can get 4 free stocks valued up to $1,400 down in the description if you deposit $100. Now, I also invest some of my portfolio into cryptocurrency, and that has gone up like crazy as well. Overall, in December 2020, my investment portfolio went up $25,397.42, and that's honestly on the conservative side. Now, I thought that month would never be topped, but in January, my portfolio went up even more, $26,633.58, which is just, I don't even know what to think. Now, you might be wondering, Shane, the video says you make $390 a day in passive income, but right there, that alone is over $600 a day. What's going on here? Well, technically speaking, it's not income because I haven't sold any of my investments. And on top of that, these 2 months were absolute freak occurrences. Like, this is not normal at all. And in a few months, I wouldn't be surprised at all if my portfolio ended up crashing by $20,000 to $25,000 as well. And so I don't think it would be very fair to put all of this as passive income. It would kind of be like cherry picking the really good months. In reality, over the long run, from what I have invested in my portfolio right now, I think a conservative estimate would be about $1,083 a month in profit. So that's what we're going to put as the passive income from my investments. Next, we're going to be talking about the second most passive type of income. And actually, I'd say this is tied for first, and that's going to be cryptocurrency staking. Now, staking is very similar to a high interest savings account, but instead of money, it's going to be cryptocurrency. Instead of getting like 0.1% back of your money every single year, you're going to be getting around 6 to 8%, sometimes even more, return from staking. Now, to be honest, I want to have a little disclaimer here. Crypto in general is pretty risky. So there's 3 things you really want to think about if you're considering investing into cryptocurrency. First of all, don't invest any more than you're willing to lose. This is probably one of the more risky types of investing. If you're somebody who doesn't have a very high risk tolerance, I would really suggest just putting your money into an index fund. That's going to be the best bang for your buck. The second thing you need to know about cryptocurrency is I invest long term. So I'm not somebody who's trying to time the market, buy and sell at different times. I invest long term. So whatever I buy, I likely won't sell for 5 to 10 years at least. And the third thing is you really need to do your research and know what you're getting yourself into. Don't just, you know, follow the opinion of somebody on the internet. Make sure you do your due diligence here. Staking is the same way. Now, there's a bunch of different websites that do this, but the one I mostly use is BlockFi.com. BlockFi has a lot of legitimate businesses that are backing them, and I trust them more than any other staking company. Now, some of the other ones you can get a little bit better yield, but generally I'm getting around 6 to 8%. So with those numbers, I'm making around $10 a day or so using BlockFi staking, which is really nice. Now, I'm very careful and I pretty much only stake like a few different types of cryptocurrency, mostly Ethereum and Bitcoin. And in December, I made around $290.70. And in January, I made around $308.30. And the cool thing about this is it's compounding interest. So all the money I make from that goes directly back into the account. And so the next month after that, it's probably going to be slightly higher. So the next type of passive income is going to be affiliate links. So let's say I do a video where I talk about a really good book on money, which is The Millionaire Next Door. And I'm just talking about, you know, some of the parts of this book that I really agree with and, you know, how maybe you should read it yourself if you want to get educated on personal finance for normal people. And I just happen to link that down in the description with an Amazon link. You go to it, you buy the book, I might end up getting like 30 cents. And there's honestly a lot of spammers out there who just like spam affiliate links. And there's also some people who promote products just because the affiliate offer is good. But I personally think overall affiliate links are amazing. And I really just think that it's a win-win situation for everyone. And I personally only promote links to products that I am already using myself. And a lot of the time, the person who buys the product is gonna get some kind of discount code. The person who's selling the product, the company themselves, are going to get an extra sale that they wouldn't have otherwise. And the person who promoted the product is going to end up getting a small cut as well. So it's a win-win situation for everyone involved. And whenever I'm thinking about buying something, I will always go to like YouTuber friends' video descriptions, or I'll text a friend for a referral link, something along those lines, just because it's literally free money. It's not like the company's upselling the person, like charging them extra just because they used an affiliate link. Nope, they're literally just giving them a discount and they're giving you a little cut as well. Seriously, Meet Kevin has probably scored like maybe $100 off of me with the affiliate links I've used in his description. And this is such a great way of making passive income because they basically just sit there wherever you put them for years. And you know, maybe 5 years down the line, an extra 100,000 people might end up watching a video and a few of them end up clicking your link. And nobody has to click on these links. You could just put Webull.com into Google and it'll pop up there as well. And then the person doesn't get the affiliate commission. But if you appreciate the person's video and you want to help them out, then it's nice to click on their link just to give them a little bit of a kickback. Now, the first year and a half that I had this YouTube channel, I had no idea what I was doing. And I actually didn't put an affiliate link in the description until I was over 100,000 subscribers. I finally started putting links in the description just a few months ago. I put Webull link and it's been doing okay. I don't really talk about it or promote it all that much, but it's been getting me a few $100 every month. And then I finally decided to put links to other companies that I really like and use in the description. And I have no idea how they're doing because I haven't checked yet. So from what I've heard, your affiliate and sponsorship earnings are supposed to be about like 1-to-1 with your YouTube channel AdSense earnings. And because of the fact that I'm not really utilizing that at all, it's nowhere near that. It's not even like 10-to-1. Like it's not even 1/10 of what I earn with AdSense. So in December, I earned around $316.94. And in January, it was $405.07 from affiliate links. The numbers are not in yet, but I do think that February is going to be a little bit better. It's probably going to be over $1,000. Next on the list, we're going to be talking about Patreon. And this is basically a platform outside of YouTube where people can pay for exclusive content. No, not OnlyFans, Patreon. This is something I started because a lot of people were requesting this. And basically, I keep this extremely minimalistic. So basically, people who can't wait for me to come out with a video about whatever subject they want, they can go to my Patreon and I sort of just have like some lists there that would probably help them out. I have a subjective degree ranking list, an objective degree ranking list, and then I also talk about what my investments are as well. I'm thinking about maybe making the Patreon into more of a sort of news sort of thing, where if I see really big opportunities come out, like a really good investment or maybe some kind of program, some sort of certification where you can maybe like $100,000 with just a 6-month certification, something along those lines, where it wouldn't be the type of content that would be good enough to make a full video from it, but I can make like a really quick video where I talk about it on Patreon. I'm thinking about doing something like that with it, but right now I'm just keeping it super minimalistic. Let me know what I should do with the Patreon down in the comments. I'm actually really curious what you guys think. Hey guys, quick pause here. I'm in the editing process right now, and for some reason there were some issues with the last part of the video, so instead of going over that and trying to fix that, I've just decided to kind of cut in here and just go over the numbers instead on my spreadsheet right now. And basically, when it comes to YouTube AdSense, you can check out the video that I made on my YouTube income. But when it comes to YouTube AdSense, I would say the passive part of YouTube AdSense, aka people finding my videos through search results, and then sometimes finding my videos through discovery on the right-hand side, the videos that you see on the right-hand side when you're on the computer, and at the bottom when you're on phone. I say I make about $100 a day, or $3,000 a month, and I would say that's relatively conservative, because there's been several times where I've stopped uploading to the channel, and it seems to just promote my older videos more when I stop uploading, so it doesn't really seem like it affects my passive income or active income all that much. Although when I upload a lot of new videos, it does tend to kind of boost the algorithm a little bit, but it honestly doesn't go down all that much. Now, if I stopped uploading for like several months or something like that, who knows what would happen, but I would say conservatively speaking, I could still make around $100 a day if I stopped uploading. So that's going to be about $3,000 a month when it comes to YouTube passive income from AdSense. And so when you add everything up in total, when it comes to passive income for the month of December, it's $4,815.64. And for the month of January, it's $4,935.37. So very similar months. For February, I do believe that my passive income overall did go down a little bit. My investments didn't do as well. The market did sort of crash around the end of February. Not everything is in right now. But affiliate income definitely went up for February. AdSense was down just a little bit. And then everything else was about normal. So I'd say February might be slightly down from all of these numbers. But that's something that you would kind of expect to happen towards the beginning of the year. January, February do tend to be lower earning months. But yeah, just wanted to jump in here instead of refilming the entire video, just do this little edit at the very end. If you haven't done it already, go ahead and check out my other videos right here. I made them just for you. And yeah, that whole other intro, like, subscribe, all that stuff. Thanks guys. Have a good one.